come on, man. Torch anything of military value. Set fire to the railroads and factories.
Watch as he uses his favorite weapon. The heavens is one expansive lurid fire.
It looks like the Confederates are going west to Tennessee and Alabama.
Yeah. That seems kind of far. Do you want to go for me? Take like 60,000 soldiers. I'll take the other 60,000. I need to go to the beach to destroy Confederate morale and scare those Georgians like chickens covered in kerosene.
Wait, what?
Thomas, keep your goddamn head on straight.
It is!
These Confederates need to learn that their government cannot protect them from invaders. We need to prove that we have the power, not them. This may not be war, but rather statesmanship.
Why am I going west?
Well, that shithead Confederate John Bell Hood wants us to follow him into Tennessee. That chicken shit left Georgia wide open. You deal with Hood.
But Winter, doesn't Lincoln have a problem? He wanted you to wait until he got reelected.
We'll have the best of liberal foraging. And I persuaded Lincoln and Grant to go with me, too. Besides, Lincoln's been reelected. We march today.
Sherman sets off through Georgia towards Savannah. By plan to scare the Southerners into not joining the Confederate Army. He splits his troops into two groups to confuse the Confederate general, William Hardy. Half of the troops are with General Howard from Tennessee, the 15th Corps under Osbeas, and 17th Corps under Blair Jr. The other half are with General Slocum from Georgia, with the 14th Corps under Davis and 20th under Williams. The group march about 30 miles apart, breaking a trail 60 miles wide of destruction. Through the march, they destroy and consume over 5 million pounds of crops, free slaves, and destroy over 300 miles of railroad. The people in Georgia nicknamed them bummers. They spread fear through Georgia. They wanted to send a message that seceding maybe wasn't that great of an idea.
You know, seceding was a shit idea. My card!
We just took your fort. What are you gonna do about it now?
Take Savannah onward!
Yeah?
Today's march on sandy roads and through woods chiefly pines, though as yet we still see oaks and other trees. Good farms along the traveled roads and crops have all been good. We hardly see any cotton, corn almost exclusively instead, for which we are much obliged. We often laugh over President Jefferson Davis's idea that Sherman's army will be starved out. Never was an army so bountifully supplied.
This contraband is no good. They're taking our space, our food, and our supplies. As if we need these flags here. Cut down the bridge.
What the fuck? No, you just killed a bunch of slaves.
Did I? Or did you?
Fuck this, I'm out of here.
No, you're staying with us forever.
Sherman presented Mayor Richard Arnold with 150 guns and plenty of ammunition. Also about 25,000 bales of cotton. This was a huge moral boost for the Union. The newspapers covered it heavily, and it helped Lincoln get reelected. Sherman also issued Special Field Order No. 15, which gave each family of newly freed slaves 40 acres of land seized from plantations and a mule. However, the march also frightened the South due to the Great Destroyer's path of destruction. They left the countryside weak and demoralized, without food or much shelter. He was a southern villain and a northern hero.
For 10 months, trench warfare has raged between Union forces under General Ulysses S. Grant and Confederate forces under Robert E. Lee around the Fort of Petersburg, the gateway to the Confederate capital, Richmond. Richmond has served as the most important city in the Confederacy because of its status as an industrial hub and military headquarters, as well as its symbolic value to the South. Now, in April of 1865, Confederate forces have run out of supplies, and Lee must decide his next move.
Lieutenant General Gordon, what's the latest from the front?
General Lee, I have received word that the Union forces under that bastard, Philip Sheridan, have just overran our forces at Five Forks. They'll be able to storm Petersburg and reach Richmond any day now.
Defending Richmond has always been a burden. Perhaps it's time to abandon our efforts there. What do you propose, Lieutenant General Gordon?
Well, you see, I actually think we should first try to seek peace terms. In these terms, if these are unacceptable terms, then we can retreat from Richmond. Perhaps join up with General Joseph E. Johnston? He's still in the Carolinas.
Peace.
Yes.
Peace.
Yes, peace.
Peace?
We still have a fighting chance, Lieutenant General Gordon.
Whatever you say.
Then it's decided. The remainder of my army of about 30,000 men will abandon the Petersburg defenses. Although Richmond will inevitably fall to the enemy, this action will allow us to continue the fight for at least 2 more years. We will march down to North Carolina and link up with General Johnston. Our combined forces will then destroy the Union forces under William Tecumseh Sherman.
Brilliant plan. Shall I telegraph President Jefferson Davis?
Yes. Also prepare our men. We will evacuate on the night of April the 2nd.
Yes, sir.
No, Jesus.
Oh. Urgent message from General Lee.
Prepare, tell the government to make preparations. If worse comes to worse, we leave at 8:30 tonight.
Okay, let's go.
Well, it's 8:30, but I've still got time. I know Lee will defeat those Yankees and Richmond will be safe. Oh, it's 10 o'clock. I should be getting good news from Lee any minute now. He's so cute. 11 o'clock. As much as it pains me, I must leave. We will continue the fight in Danville.
Listen up, y'all. I have orders to burn all the food and alcohol in the city before the Union gets here. So put it in this building and we'll burn it.
No!
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 Hell, men, put out this fire. With the fire under control, President Lincoln can finally enter the city safely.
Good day, General Witzel.
President Lincoln, allow me to take you on a tour of the city.
Dear Lord, that bastard Gordon. I can't take this bad news anymore. can't trust no one to follow orders and do things right these days. However, I'm beginning to fear the worst. Things don't look right for us. There's nothing left for me to do but go and see General Grant, and I would rather die 1,000 deaths. Go and tell General Grant I am willing to meet him where we had previously decided. Hurry.
Okay.
Telegraph from General Lee. He wants to meet at the old meeting spot to determine the future of his army.
Huh, has he really had enough already? That coward. However, we will not meet him there. We will meet at Appomattox Courthouse. Wilmer McLean, that poor bastard, he moved there to escape the war, and now we're going to his house to settle this. I want to surrender. Tell General Lee the new meeting spot.
Okay. General Grant wants to meet at Appomattox Courthouse to decide your surrender.
Thank you. Tell my generals to spread the word to stop fighting. This war is coming to an end, and there doesn't need to be any more bloodshed. We've already lost 400 and taken the lives of over 260 Indians. What a shame. Go.
What a shame.
We both know why we're here. You suck ass, and you need my mercy. I'm willing to show you some. I'll be the better man here.
Thank you.
You and your army of Northern Virginia are to surrender your weapons. And never take them up against the Union ever again. Your soldiers are to be sent home and out of battle for good. Your men can keep their horses and their mules, and I will supply some rations as well.
Well, thank you, sir.
The war is over. The rebels are our countrymen again, and the best sign of rejoicing after the victory will be to abstain from all demonstrations in the field. Now let's go home and get some grub. What the fuck? I can't see anything.
Oh dear Lincoln, what will Miss Harris think of my hanging on to you so?
She won't think anything of it.
What time is it here?
10:15.
The Souther's avenged freedom! Six different TM for your eternity's sake!
I have a doctor sitting nearby. This man was shot in the head.
What about me?
You're not the president. You don't matter.
I'm the guard. I was here. I don't know how this happened. I was totally here, not at a tavern trying to pick up cheap hookers. I was here.
I personally think Andrew Jackson was connected to Booth. I mean, all evidence points to it. Just look at the evidence. Booth showed up at Johnson's hotel and left a note saying, "Don't wish to disturb you. Are you home?" Congress members believe Johnson was part of an assassination committee too. Maybe there was some sort of relations between the two, or Johnson just wanted the throne.
Don't listen to Shakira. You see, Lincoln's assassination was all a Confederate plot. They even planned to blow up the White House. Man, Booth was working under Jefferson Davis. He was part of all the plan.
I personally believe that the assassination was due to international bankers that disliked his monetary policies. Lincoln refused European loans, which upset all the international bankers. The Rothschild just wanted to weaken the economy to take it over.
I have come from beyond the grave to inform you that the assassination was a working of the Catholic Church. Booth was a tool of the Jesuits. You should all remember how Lincoln defended me in court and I won, which must have left the bishops I sued upset.
busted in the back, diamond fangs in my grill. Brooklyn brim with my eyes sitting low.